you so much for joining us today for Weather Center Live. I'm meteorologist Maria LaRosa.
And I'm meteorologist Kate Park. Okay, this week we've got damage that has just been prolific. Every day we have a new spot, and last night, no exception.
And everybody now, this morning, cleaning up and into the afternoon. So one of the big stories we're covering, recovering from storms. Hundreds of thousands in the dark, cars flipped, trees down. We're going to take a look at the damage caused by some of these intense storms from last night in the Northeast.
But what's next? Yeah, another day of severe. Look at this. This swath of severe weather expected across South Dakota on into Illinois once again. And we could see damaging winds. We could see big hail. And we could even see an isolated tornado. And that goes into tonight, Maria.
And that's one show in the sky. How about this one? You've seen video pictures of the Northern Lights, but I guarantee you not like this. We go in depth to show you who could see this light, including in the southern part of the U.S. Kate.
Yeah, let's go ahead and show you some amazing yet scary moments from last night's storms.
It's gonna go. If that wind is crazy. Oh, it's gonna go. There it goes. There it goes.
Oh.
I did it.
Oh.
That's gone. That's gone.
There it goes.
There it goes.
It missed the whole, every house.
Isn't that crazy? It missed the house, the car. Very intense moments in New Jersey Tuesday afternoon as those strong thunderstorms pounded the state. This was the scene in Maple Shade Township, east of Philadelphia. That heavy rain, the strong winds toppled the trees. It knocked out power to tens of thousands of people. Now in nearby Medford, two people were treated after a tree fell on a car. We'll have more scenes like this in just a moment, but Kate, you've got to look at where that severe weather is today.
Yeah, a lot of thunder, a lot of lightning, some pretty potent storms out there right now. Really have slowed down across Illinois, but this is where we're zooming in on. Look at this. Sioux City, here we come. A lot of thunder, a lot of lightning on tap for you. This not currently designated as a severe thunderstorm, but probably just below the criteria there. It's going to be passing over I-29 as well. So if you know anybody that's trying to, you know, leave the house, if you're trying to go out and run some errands, or maybe you're just trying to get out on the road, stay out of this area. South of Sioux City into Ottawa, that's where that strong thunderstorm making its way through, just through Wakefield right now. A lot of thunder and lightning with that one. Here's what we've got going on across Illinois. Now, we obviously have a lot of cleanup efforts underway across Illinois today. After 9 tornadoes there were reported and confirmed just 2 days ago. So what's happening today? We have more rain in the forecast. We have more thunderstorms in the forecast. But what exactly does that look like? Where will it be? A little more of a focus off toward the west. Davenport, you're going to be a spot that we watch today. Des Moines, Omaha, even into Rapid City. Possibility for some large hail. You could see some damaging winds. And we also have Torcons out. In fact, for southern Iowa, you have a Torcon of 4. And then getting into Illinois, western in central Illinois, you have a Torcon of 3, which means 30% chance of seeing a tornado within 50 miles of those given spots. So what's the culprit here? Just this moisture is on the loose out of the Gulf of Mexico. This warm front, really where we're going to be focusing today. This whole area out ahead of it and right along it. We've got the low-level jet in place. This relaxes a little during the day, but at night it kicks right back in. We've got that strong mid-level jet. I mean, it's a possibility with these turning winds with height that we could see those thunderstorms turn a bit as well, Maria.
And put down a lot of heavy rain. So along with all of that, we have to be concerned about the flash flooding. The setup is there, and we have the same players leading to that. So we have our strong area of low pressure. We have the slow-moving fronts at the surface, but there's a lot going on as we get in through tonight that'll continue that storm threat and that heavy rain threat. We have lots of moisture available. That's in place, and it's all beginning to push up and over that warm front. And then you have the jet stream that's kind of in line, parallel to the motion of that, the winds on the front. And that's going to lead to training. And training is basically like you think, trains on a track. The storms are the train cars, and they're going over and over the same spot several times. And so that's going to add up when it comes to rainfall. So if you took a 3-hour time period, what would it take to flood an area? Well, some of the guidance suggesting about 1.5 to 2 inches in a 3-hour time period would be enough to flash flood. And you can see that it's from Iowa into Illinois. And that's exactly what we have in the forecast for maybe more than 3 inches as we get in through tomorrow. And within that 3-hour time period, definitely possible here as we go through the next few hours with these series of thunderstorms. So we have a number of flash flood watches that have been posted for Chicago, for Davenport, Peoria. Again, these are the areas that were hard hit with storms. So something that is not needed right now is heavy rain in those areas that are still trying to clean. clean up, Kate.
Right, another area that's cleaning up this morning, Maria, the Philadelphia area. Dangerous storms rolled through last night. Look at this video here. Winds gusted to 70 miles an hour. We saw flipped vehicles. We saw trees knocked down. That cut power to more than 370,000 customers just in that area. And within 15 minutes, there were more than 625 lightning strikes. So a lot of lightning with this as well. Now, the storms did come near right after those near record high temperatures. We actually had a heat advisory in effect before those storms rolled on through. And in Greenwich, New Jersey, check out this damage. This is an auto parts store where in Cumberland County, we saw 900 people without power. Those winds obviously were intense last night, and a lot of power outages because it was a very wide area, very highly populated area that those thunderstorms roared through. So how does that compare, right, to Winter Storm Nemo? Well, last night's storms, we had 828,000 customers without power. Back during Winter Storm Nemo, if you remember that, February 2013, that prolonged huge storm, we had only over 650,000 power outages. So we had more last night thanks to the wind and the potency of those storms. Look at the progression of this. These are all storm reports that you see here, right? Look at this. Man, you get a lot of reports there, and that's because of this kind of bowing out feature here to those cluster of thunderstorms, those little individual discrete cells. They become one, and then at night, once the sun starts to go down, notice this is about 11 p.m., low-level jet gets a little higher, gets a little stronger. We see that the carrying on of some of those winds a little bit longer than you would typically see after losing the kind of the heat of the day. So those are the storm reports, Maria. I know that you have a lot of family in this area. You're from this area, and you were hearing a lot of things from them.
Yeah, they definitely had the gusty winds. Nobody sustained any damage, thank goodness, but you can see how widespread that is and can actually do more damage than, say, a singular tornado. So you have to keep that in mind with those kinds of thunderstorms and that setup.
Yeah, so we have more of those in the forecast today, right? We're going to talk about today's severe weather threat, potential for dangerous flooding in the Midwest,
and also a look at where in the world the most lightning strikes occur, and I'm telling you, the answer might surprise you.
As soon as I say that.
Growing up, we were German. We danced in a German dance group. I wore lederhosen. When I first got on Ancestry, I was really surprised that I wasn't finding all of these Germans in my tree. I decided to have my DNA tested through Ancestry DNA. The big surprise was we're not German at all. 52% of my DNA comes from Scotland and Ireland. So I traded in my lederhosen for a kilt.
Ancestry has many paths to discovering your story. Get started for free at Ancestry.com.
This is the Andersons' new Honda Accord LX. The car that will get them up and out for the evening with more horsepower and torque than a Ford Fusion S. With better fuel efficiency to help use less gas getting there. And because it has more interior space, they can arrive comfortably for their reservation. No wonder the Accord is the best value in America. Start something special with the Accord.
Bridgestone is changing the game in tire performance.
So will Arnett can get to the store when he's out of diapers.
Well, to be clear, they're not for me. For my son. So
we should probably go.
We switched Will's tires to Bridgestone's revolutionary Drive Guard tires.
Oh, those look sharp.
It's okay. Our Drive Guard tires are engineered to take a puncture and drive up to 50 miles on a flat. So no side of the road.
Well, that's good because the side of the road is dangerous, especially since we're going commando.
We're?
What commando mean?
Monday on Altered Course.
I don't care who you put in our way, we're gonna take them down.
It's go time.
I don't think anybody can outrun us, outtrain us.
It's do or die.
Come on.
Yes. Oh my God.
Altered Course Montego Bay, Monday at 9 p.m. Eastern on Golf Channel.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, intervals of clouds and sunshine. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Tomorrow morning, tracking storms that could bring wind damage and flooding into your Thursday commute. Plus, will we finally get relief from the southern heat? Wake up with Al and AMHQ tomorrow morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Aren't you Kristen Press?
That's me.
Great to see you off the soccer field.
What's that sunscreen?
It's Coppertone Clearly Sheer. Lightweight, breathable protection.
Your skin looks amazing, not greasy.
Try it.
Heads up.
Show off.
I heard that.
Coppertone Clearly Sheer.
Brought to you by Coppertone Sunscreen.
Zantac Heartburn Alert! Stop! Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
Please rise for our national anthem.
This moment of independence brought to you by your U.S. Army.
Let's do this. Don't think it's possible? Think again. With the summer's best savings, the upgrades are better than ever. So, let's go for the bells and the whistles. Fridges that open like this. And, whoa, did you see that? It's time to reset our expectations. Right now, it's all within reach. Let's do this. Get a Samsung washer, dryer, or fridge, each just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
Can you think of anything more beautiful and dangerous at the same time than lightning? I can't. I mean, every time a thunderstorm rolls through, you get to see Mother Nature's most raw form of power, lightning. And you know what? NASA just came out with a really cool looking map that shows where the highest concentrations of lightning are. This is the average yearly counts of lightning flashes per square kilometer from 1995 to 2013. You might think Florida's the lightning capital of the world. Well, there's a lot of lightning there, but it's not the capital. You notice in Central Africa there? That's the Democratic Republic of Congo, and that's where some of the most intense lightning on the planet is. Also, northwestern South America, up into parts of Venezuela. And this data is from lightning imaging sensors on two different satellites.
Now you know, when you go to the water cooler today, that's where the most lightning strikes in the world are. But what about the United States? Well, we have a few shots of lightning that we've seen this week from Michigan, New Jersey, Tennessee, and of course, Florida.
A lot of these probably not shot in the safest of ways. You know, if you are going to be in or around lightning, mm-hmm. in a car is your, you know, desperate choice. You right. should definitely be inside.
Yes.
And especially in these areas that get it most often, you should be used to it, right?
Right.
This is the highest frequency here, right along the Gulf Coast, on into Florida. And then you'll notice these little pockets, though, Maria.
Yeah, I thought that was kind of interesting. But, you know, it makes sense where you're seeing the most frequency is along the Gulf Coast and where you see a lot of storms, especially this time of year. It's Lightning Safety Awareness Week, so we want to make sure that you kind of know some of the stats here. And, of course, it makes sense, too. The West Coast is relatively quiet when it comes to lightning.
Right. But, you know, whenever you're talking about lightning per square mile, mm-hmm. how do these states rank? Florida, clearly number one. Tampa, the lightning capital of the U.S. They're almost the world. It's up there. Not quite, but, you know, a lot.
Fascinating. Yeah, and the way it's broken down, too, more than 1.2 million strikes on average a year. But you've got a couple of interesting states, too, that have cracked the top 10. You know, some of them make sense. You know, Mississippi's high on the list there, Alabama. But also Illinois cracking number 8 with more than 800,000 strikes on average, but 14.4 per square mile. That's significant.
You got a little more square mileage there, you know, mm-hmm. to spread out the wealth in.
Yeah.
So that's why it ranks a little lower.
And I'll tell you, Tennessee was lighting up last night. When you capture that perfect lightning strike on video, you get kind of excited. Take a look.
Oh, yeah. There it is again. I don't think it's going to get to us, guys. Oh, as soon as I say that, I hope you enjoy it as much as
I do. Yes, we feel the excitement. We feel you.
There it is again.
We want to make this our ringtone and like just one of those buttons.
As soon as I say that.
I have buttons over here. Can we somehow route this?
Oh, yeah.
I need to talk to our technical support. I just need that button, that oh yeah button.
But, you know, vivid lightning. In just a span of 15 minutes, there were more than 4,000 lightning strikes in this area, Parsons, Tennessee, between Memphis and Nashville.
It's not just Jim Cantore that gets psyched about weather, people.
Right.
It's not just him.
There it is.
I love
Hunter Lee, you love love it too.
I love it.
We love you for it.
We're addicted to it. But you know, again, lightning is powerful. It's beautiful. It's happening right now,
right.
And we're tracking some thunderstorms with quite a bit of it.
Look at this, right in Sioux City.
That.
Man, that is a lot of lightning, dangerous, excessive lightning. Omaha as well, right on top of you.
And this is all an area, as you can see, nothing severe right now, although this one's probably packing some good amount of wind and lots of heavy rain, just about ready to cross I-29 between Omaha and Sioux City. But it really is today, this afternoon, that you've got that whole area under the gun potentially for severe weather.
Yeah, Rapid City all the way to Davenport, and that swath, I mean, we could see isolated tornado. Mm-hmm. Not out of the question, especially when you consider what else we've seen this week.
Right.
You want to make sure that you're on top of getting the kids inside. You hear thunder, mm-hmm. get indoors.
So the Torcons are out, but we also have some flash flood watches posted across the Midwest, so we'll take a look at that.
Yeah, plus why the Aurora Borealis is invisible so much farther south than normal? This is a cool one.
Beautiful job. I knew you had it in you. And it was easy because of what I have in me. You know, the color-rich technology and all-climate protection package? It penetrates deep for long-lasting protection and beauty. And I'm the only one who's got it. Olympic Elite. For exceptional beauty and protection that lasts. Olympic. Simply done. Exclusively at Lowe's. Introducing Olympic Rescue It Light. Transform lightly worn wood and concrete into beautiful barefoot-friendly surfaces. Stop by Lowe's and save $5 per gallon.
You ever feel like you're spinning?
Like you're stuck in the same place in life? Just going round and round and round? Yeah, man. Been there.
No, actually spinning.
Oh, we can fix that by going to Midas. They have a great selection of tires. Sorry, Doug, I thought you were trying to get deep.
It's time to take a closer look at your tires. Get up to $140 back by mail on a set of four Goodyear, Cooper, and other select brands. Tires, brakes, oil, everything. Trust the Midas Touch.
As the host of my own home improvement show, I know how difficult finding a home service pro can be. Now there's an easy way. HomeAdvisor.com. It's a free service that instantly connects you with top local service pros.
You can use HomeAdvisor for everything. Your house cleaning, your painting.
For plumbers, electrical, yeah. Concrete.
It's more than a list. It's reviews. It's background screening.
If I can use it, anybody can use it. It's that simple.
Very, very easy to use. And it's free.
HomeAdvisor. Bop, 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 bop.
Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ. The whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Create some fireworks of your own during City Furniture's July 4th sale. A complete queen bedroom, $9.99. A bonded leather reclining sofa, $5.99. A five-piece dining set, $4.99. And find even more July 4th specials at cityfurniture.com. Plus, get same-day delivery and no interest till 2017. Right now at City Furniture.
Are you frustrated with digestive issues that keep coming back? Try Digestive Advantage, a unique, natural probiotic that survives better. While probiotics in yogurts and other leading supplements may not survive as well, Digestive Advantage survives 100 times better, so it can get where you need it. Take control of your digestive health with Digestive Advantage Daily Probiotic.
Tomorrow morning, tracking storms that could bring wind damage and flooding into your Thursday commute. Plus, will we finally get relief from the southern heat? Wake up with Al and AMHQ tomorrow morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8, brought to you by Off Mosquito Protection.
The Off Outdoor Refresher Course. Sunsets. Hello, you. And you, too. Meet outside, where the golden hour is approaching, along with the Buzzy Suck Squad. It's been a while, but you can do this. Step 1, open door. Step 2, activate off clip-on. Mosquito protection you don't spray on. Step 3, face west. Get back out there with off clip-on. Keep bugs off.
SC Johnson, a family company.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, intervals of clouds and sunshine. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Past the hour, the National Weather Service has now confirmed that an EF3 tornado hit the small town of Coal City, Illinois on Monday, making it the strongest in the Chicago metro area in nearly 25 years. It's estimated the tornado may have roared through with winds over 160 miles per hour, carving a path of over 16 miles. Thankfully, there were no deaths or life-threatening injuries reported. The governor has declared two Illinois counties state disaster areas, and it's easy to understand why, Kate, with video like that. The damage, just incredible.
Incredible stuff. And we're hoping to prevent some more damage today, or at least keep you safe if there is any. Let's talk about Omaha, where you are just feeling it right now. Look at this. It's ominous in Omaha. You've got some very dark clouds. This isn't giving you a true perspective on just how strong this thunderstorm is that's right on your tail. So the thing is that with this, Omaha, you've got the College World Series games. This time last year, I was actually up there in Omaha right around the same time. Do you remember those giant hailstorms that roared through? I mean, it tore the siding off of buildings, and you did have a couple tornadoes in the area as well. So we're just kind of keeping you aware of what's going on. In fact, look at this. Like I was saying, that the view there on that tower cam, not painting the whole picture, because look how much lightning we have in Omaha. And just to the north in Sioux City, woo, a lot of lightning. Des Moines, now you're getting into the game. This is right along the warm front. This is what we've been expecting to see all day. 29, a tough place to travel right now. You know, if you're just traveling south, or you know anybody traveling south into Sioux City, and they're just starting to encounter some of that rain, I would say get off the highway, pull over for a few minutes, let this pass before you continue on that southward track. I would say do the same thing in Omaha, because it's going to be blinding rain. It's going to put them into danger. Let's talk about this severe thunderstorm warning way to the south now. Jasper County, look at this. I mean, did you even think that we were going to be going down into Mississippi today? Well, we are. 1:15 p.m. Central Time. That's how long that severe thunderstorm warning goes. And then Wayne County until 12:45. So take cover in Laurel. It's heading your direction, Maria.
So we have a pretty big area that we're covering today for the severe threat, including in Illinois. High winds, hail, tornadoes. Tornadoes possible. Ed Fenelon from the National Weather Service in Chicago joins us now. And Ed, thank you so much for taking time with us. We've got a lot of things on our plate here in the Chicago area, from the severe threat, the flash flooding threat, and timing is everything too, because it could be impacting the evening rush. Tell me about the next few hours and what your concerns are.
Yes, indeed, and good afternoon, everybody. And as you mentioned, as what has seemed to be all too frequent the case here the past several days here in Chicago, we are faced with both a severe weather threat and a flash flood threat as we move through the evening hours and into the overnight. Now, initially, we may see a few scattered storms as early as late afternoon, but really the severe threat with any of those that might pop up is minimal. And again, the better chances are going to come into this evening. Now, as we look for stronger thunderstorms to develop out to the west of Chicago this evening, we're expecting them to move into the area here and move east. Merging into a line of storms. So initially with that, we're going to be concerned about a concentrated area of straight line winds with these storms, and then certainly some risk of large hail and even a brief weak tornado with that. But then as we move on into the evening hours, later on into the evening, we'll likely see some backbuilding of thunderstorms causing a bit of a training effect, kind of almost like cars on a freight train going down the tracks with one thunderstorm following the next in a line. And with that, we get the potential to just produce prolific rainfall. And with these thunderstorms this evening into the overnight, those storms may be capable of rainfall amounts, or rates rather, of 1 to 2 inches per hour, with total rainfall amounts on the order of 1 to 4 inches expected, maybe even a few isolated higher amounts of 5 inches out there. So this certainly is going to exacerbate any of the current high water and the flooding situations that are ongoing, especially in areas just to the south of the Chicago area.
Wow, so much going on and such terrific information. Ed, we can't thank you enough. From the National Weather Service in Chicago, that office there has been busy this week.
And it's going to be a long day for them, too, into the night.
Okay, so we know how dangerous lightning can be. It's Lightning Safety Awareness Week. But what about while you're flying?
So coming up, Chris Warren takes us inside the research lab at Boeing to find out how safe airplanes are when it comes to lightning.
At last.
Sometimes at last doesn't happen at first.
My love has come along. My lonely days.
Your dad just kissed my mom.
Are over.
Turning two worlds into one takes love.
And life is like a song.
Helping protect that world takes State Farm.
In the summertime, when the weather is fine, you can stretch right up into the sky. When it's vacation time, you got MSC Cruises on your mind. Have a drink, relax, you're gonna have a good time. Sail along with us at MSC. See your fabulous show and be happy.
Cruise the world with MSC Cruises. Call your travel agent or visit msccruises.com.
Tired of running up and down ladders for the right size screwdriver? Frustrated when you can't find a bit that fits? Hi, David Jones with Bit 360, the revolutionary 6-in-1 screwdriver where all you do is slide, twist, and lock the right bit for the perfect fit every time. Uh-oh, wrong bit? With Bit 360, you change from a Phillips to a flathead just that fast. For six different screws, you need six different tools. But with Bit 360 and our high-speed camera, we get a grip on all these screws in a matter of seconds. Amazing. The secret is the quick change chamber that revolves 360 degrees with each bit securely inside. Just slide, twist, and lock, and now you're loaded with the right bit for the perfect fit. And Bit 360 is magnetized, so the screws stay securely on the bit without falling. Bit 360 comes with six preloaded bits to fit virtually any screw, or add your own bits to get a grip on any job around the house, in the workshop, the garage, or on the job site. Best of all, everything stays contained in one compact handheld tool to keep handy in a drawer. One Bit 360 fits all these different sizes and types of screws. Now that's versatility.
Bit 360 is everything I need right where I need it.
I love Bit 360 because it combines all of my screwdrivers into one tool.
Bit 360 is perfect for moms, a great gift for dads, and comes with a one-year money-back guarantee. So you can spend over $50 on a set of screwdrivers, or you can lock and load with the Bit 360 for only $10. And if you call now, we'll double the offer and send a second Bit 360 free. Just pay separate processing and handling. That's two Bit 360s, a $20 value for only $10. Here's how to order.
To order the Bit 360 for $10 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-519-0875. That's 1-800-519-0875 or order online at buybit360.com.
Climate change, of course, has a lot to do with the Middle East, more than people realize. After all, Syria experienced the worst drought in its modern history from 2006 to 2010. Those were the 4 years leading up to the Syrian revolution.
The Weather Channel presents 25 Unexpected Voices. Hear their stories at climate25.com.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, intervals of clouds and sunshine. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Tomorrow
morning tracking storms that could bring wind damage and flooding into your Thursday commute. Plus, will we finally get relief from the southern heat? Wake up with Al and AMHQ tomorrow morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Intense.
Visuals like
on the same wavelength.
Right there.
We got
right
it.
There.
We got it there. Okay, thanks for staying with us on Weather Center Live. I'm meteorologist Kate Barker.
And I'm meteorologist Maria LaRosa. And it was intense all across the Northeast. Take a look.
And my damn slippers are wet. Look at this. Right up out the ground. Holy mackerel. Oh, there's some siding for somebody. Ooh! That's a mess.
Ooh, indeed. A scene repeated dozens, if not hundreds of times at homes across the Northeast this morning. People just venturing out, trying to see all the damage from last night's thunderstorms. But now the storm threat is through the plains. Kate has more on that.
Yeah, let's talk about this. This area today that's on, once again on your guard. You should be. I know you're kind of getting storm fatigue because this time of year it seems like it's day in, day out. You have to be prepared for severe weather. But today it's Rapid City to Davenport. This swath has the possibility of some very large hail. You could see some damaging winds. But we've got Torcons today. A Torcon of 4 for southern Iowa. We've got a Torcon of 3 for portions of Illinois. This is going to include, you know, Springfield, Peoria, that area. That's where that Torcon of 3 Mattoon, Illinois, Eastern Illinois University, right in there as well. Take a look at this low-level flow. This is just making its way all the way up into the northern plains, and this is really feeding into that warm front. When that warm front scoots to the north, we're just seeing that moisture surge north as well. So that's one of the features that we're watching today. Right along the warm front is where a lot of these thunderstorms that could initialize and be pretty strong will be located, will be right along that. But we also have this strong winds and a little bit higher up in the atmosphere. Not at the surface, but a little higher up. But you'll notice these winds, see how they're coming out of the southeast. Look at these, the southwest. It's a little bit of turning with height. So that's why we're concerned for some stronger thunderstorms that could produce hail. We could possibly even see an isolated tornado. Let's go ahead and take a live look at Omaha, Nebraska. Whoo, man, some intense clouds there. The College Baseball World Series ongoing in Omaha, Nebraska. And this time of year, it seems like a very difficult spot to have that series because you have near daily severe weather there. And today, no exception. Look at this. You've got that jet stream in the mid-levels that's really strong, going to help carry this low along that disturbance on off toward the east. So Des Moines, a spot that we are expecting maybe one or two thunderstorms. You've got one on top of you right now. You get a break, but then look at this. When the kids are getting in bed, they're going to hear some of those rumbles of thunder, and they may end up in bed with you instead, Maria.
Yeah, that's and your pets, too,
right?
By the way. But we've got our eyes on storms in a lot of places. Chicago is definitely one that we're keeping an eye on. You see everyone kind of hanging out. Well, you've got your cubbies at home tonight. First pitch, I believe, is 7 o'clock, 7:05 Central Time, and that could be a stormy time of day for the Chicagoland area. And it's certainly one area we're watching as we get in through tonight, because that severe threat today moves off to the east tonight, and there is still very much a severe threat, and that includes Chicago, it includes Des Moines, as well as Sioux Falls and Rapid City, Champaign too, all along this area producing heavy rain. So some of those similar areas, we've got the flash flood watch, includes Waterloo, Des Moines, Davenport, and Chicago, and timing is everything. We are going to be very watchful of what develops this afternoon, because it could play out as a very big, dangerous cluster of thunderstorms with the power to put down very strong winds over a large distance. And you look at the timestamp there, yeah, this could be a real mess for the morning drive. And imagine if this is move just a little bit to the north, and we've got Chicago in on it, as well as Indianapolis. So, Kate, Chicago, storms through the afternoon and evening, or I should say into the evening and towards the morning hours.
And then we're just going to pick that right back up and go right into tomorrow with a severe threat. Let's break it down for you. Similar setup, a little farther to the east. And the dynamics not quite as on point for some of those stronger rotating updrafts. Let's talk about this moist low-level flow still going to be a thing. You still have that warm front, but you'll notice the jet stream right on top of it, right? This is the clear direction that we're going to see those showers and thunderstorms move. And that's one of the things that we're worried about for maybe some flash flooding potential. Whenever you get those showers moving over the same area over and over again, you have problems. Tomorrow, this is the area where we're concerned about hail. Isolated tornadoes, not out of the question there. High wind, it's going to be right across I-70, KC to St. Louis. You go into Indianapolis, over to Washington, D.C., down into Norfolk, you have that potential there. And then as you head into Friday, look at this. It's the same area from Fort Smith and then making our way all the way back that direction to Norfolk, a little farther to the south. But Friday, once again, Maria, more of those thunderstorms.
And we want to make sure everyone's aware of it. It's actually Lightning Safety Awareness Week this week. And with any storm comes the threat of lightning. But how dangerous is it for aircraft? Well, this video shows back in March when lightning struck a plane during its approach to Seattle SeaTac Airport. The plane unbelievably managed to land safely without incident. What might surprise you is that during a lightning storm, being in an airplane is actually one of the safest places to be. Meteorologist Chris Warren visited the Boeing test facility in Seattle to find out why.
Imagine this while you're in this. We know lightning can be deadly when you're on the ground, but what about an airplane? To find out, we went to the experts.
This is the Boeing Company Lightning Lab. It's a high voltage test chamber and a high current test chamber to do lightning effects on aircraft and aircraft parts.
Lightning's scary enough, but for people flying an airplane, you see lightning out the window.
Right.
Should people be scared when they see that?
Not when you're in an airplane, because the plane is designed to handle any kind of attachments to its exterior surface. The exterior surface is like a Faraday cage. All the charge will stay on the outside. It becomes a part of the channel. The current flows right through it.
To demonstrate this, they will strike this airplane model with a bolt of lightning from their own Mark's generator.
When we use this high voltage generator, we mimic what the lightning attachment is going to look like on an aircraft in flight. Whether it's on the nose, the wingtips, the tail, that's what we're going to look for. So we're ready, lights are ready, and we're charging.
It's go time?
Okay. Go time.
Just saw the test and the plane looks fine. Looks like the same as when we came in.
That's right, because this is an initial attachment test. It's a high voltage test. We do a high current test to assess the damage that's in the other room. This is a representation of a piece of aircraft skin. This is our output probe, similar to what we had in the other room, only here, instead of using 2 megavolts, we use about 50 to 60 kilovolts, but we get 200,000 amps out of it.
40 turned 50.
And here's the result. So what that arc did is it penetrated through the paint to the metal layer and discharged about 200,000 amps into that panel.
It didn't go through though, right?
No, on a panel of this equivalent thickness on the airplane, it would not go through.
It wouldn't go through. As far as nature goes, how would you compare that strike to what you'd find in nature?
That is the highest strike that you would normally see in any aircraft lifetime. From a lightning attachment such as this, you would expect to be able to turn around and fly right back.
Well, it's just another thing that you just don't worry about. Don't worry about if the plane gets hit by lightning.
That's right.
I'm meteorologist Chris Warren, the Weather Channel.
Such good information.
Go, don't worry. I got this.
People ask about that all the time, especially when we're flying on planes. You've got your Weather Channel gear on. People are like, tell us, are we safe?
I know.
Okay, so the Aurora Borealis putting on quite a show this week.
Spectacular.
Incredible.
And it's gone pretty far south. We're going to take a look at the why behind it.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Fiat 500X crossover, featuring an available Uconnect system with a 6.5-inch touchscreen and available all-wheel drive. Well-rounded, has never looked so sharp.
Let's do a reality check. Kids will be kids. Dogs will be dogs. So let's get some paint that's more than just paint. Made to stand up to this. And look beautiful for years. Let's lose the old marks and messes and stop new ones in their tracks. Let's worry-proof our walls. Let's do this.
Behr Premium Plus with easy clean finish starting at $25.97 a gallon. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
When you have a migraine, you'll reach for anything to make the pain go away. Truth is, most pain relievers don't work like Excedrin Migraine. It relieves my pain starting in 30 minutes. That's fast, plus sensitivity to light and sound.
Excedrin Migraine.
Wow, that was fast.
Now everyone who uses catheters can get a better catheter with Liberator Medical's free catheter sample pack. These new catheters are better than ever. Easier to use, more convenient, comfortable, virtually pain-free. Don't wait. Call now and get your free catheter sample pack. There's the all-new compact catheter for women. Pre-lubricated, no drips, no mess. Fits in your purse. The self-lubricated catheter. It lubricates itself in the package. Comfortable, no mess. The closed system catheter, pre-lubricated with its own collection bag, proven to reduce UTIs. The discreet pocket catheter, curved to fit in your pocket to go anywhere. The polished eyelet catheter for micro-smooth comfort, reduces friction and pain. Call now. We'll also bill Medicare and your insurance for you. Call for your free catheter sample pack with free shipping. Call Liberator Medical.
Call 1-800-601-3450. That's 1-800-601-3450.
There's a big difference between retirement and a secure retirement. Well, you may be standing right in front of the difference between uncertainty and knowing that everything's going to be all right. It's your home. Turning your home's equity into tax-free cash when you need it is a simple way to eliminate your existing monthly mortgage payments, pay off debt, and get you and your family the financial resources you need. It's a loan that your home pays back instead of you making monthly payments, the way you do with a traditional mortgage. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you may qualify for a government-insured reverse mortgage. Now, we all love our homes. Why not just stay there using a reverse mortgage with AAG? It could be the perfect solution. Call us today to receive a free information pack with no obligation that contains a helpful 3-part guide and DVD. You'll receive a guide to reverse mortgages and how they work, including the many consumer safeguards that protect you and your home. Also, our important all-new reverse mortgage retirement planner that explains the many ways a reverse mortgage could provide stability and security for your retirement. We then add a guide filled with information for children and loved ones. It's got what you need to know about reverse mortgages and how they can play a vital role in your retirement plans.
Call 1-800-816-8185 to receive our all-new information pack, all absolutely free with no obligation. Call 1-800-816-8185. That's 1-800-816-8185.
Real retirement security makes all the difference. Find out more about what a reverse mortgage can do for you.
Call 1-800-816-8185 to receive our all-new information pack, all absolutely free with no obligation. Call 1-800-816-8185. That's 1-800-816-8185.
AAG, the best advice for a better life.
This is meteorologist Mike Seidel in Chicago, out in the southwest suburbs in Joliet, Illinois, where we've been tracking rain not too far away through the morning hours, and that will continue this afternoon. Most of that staying out of the immediate Chicagoland area. said some rainfall totals, 1 to 2 inches back in Iowa. So if you're heading into Iowa or down 55, say towards Bloomington and downstate, you may find some rain this afternoon. The big threat comes tonight. We've got a Torcon of 3 right now. That may be up by Dr. Greg Forbes, our severe weather expert. What's going to happen is clusters of storms will roll down the warm front. This is the front that came through the area night before last and produced at least 9 tornadoes in the state of Illinois alone and a couple of EF3s. Now, these storms will produce heavy rain. We've got a flash flood watch kicking in this evening through Thursday morning. That's one threat, and the severe weather threat, straight line wind damage, hail, and the possibility of a tornado or two. So here's that three-day forecast for the Chicago area here in Joliet. Mostly dry today, although threatening to our south and west. And then thunderstorms tonight, especially overnight, with some locally heavy rain. The flash flood threat is certainly up there because the ground is saturated from recent rainfall. We'll keep an eye on that. And then as we get into later tomorrow and Friday, drier weather, as temperatures now into the 1st of July will be running, for the most part, below average. We've got a pattern change with a big dip in the jet stream, keeping it comfortable here in the Midwest. Kate, Maria, back to you.
Mike, thank you so much. And now to some space weather. A series of coronal mass ejections from the sun are causing quite the show here on Earth. The energy interacts with the atmosphere and is creating these dazzling auroras. And it actually could happen again tonight.
I am loving all these pictures that we're seeing all over the place. So joining us live to talk about these events is Dr. Michael Wiltberger, a scientist with the National Center for Atmospheric Research. And it is so beautiful, all the pictures that we've seen. Is there something that goes into these coronal mass ejections, a different time or a different strength that makes them more vivid or colorful versus, you know, maybe one color?
Sure. So the sun releases the coronal mass ejections. They come to the Earth and they carry a magnetic field in them. And if the magnetic field is opposite to the direction of the Earth's magnetic field, that gives you more interaction, allows more energy to come into the near Earth space and change the color of the aurora. The most typical color is green. That's what most people see. But you can see reds and blues if you're in a good spot and in a particularly nice viewing location.
And we've seen all of that, and not just in some of those typical locations, you know, like in Canada or the northern tier of the U.S. I mean, we've had reports in Arkansas, pictures from Georgia, New York City. So how rare is it to see an aurora affect areas so far south of the typical region?
Yeah, great question. So the aurora are typically seen, as you mentioned, in northern Canada and the northern latitudes. But when we get these big coronal mass ejections coming, that magnetic field pushes the aurora further south and allows them to be seen in the northern United States and even in the middle of the United States. And that's possible tonight with this coronal mass ejection that's expected to arrive around 7 p.m. Eastern.
Okay, so we should set our cameras up, I guess. And just one last question. What is a good, I guess, aurora season? Is it now during the summer or is it a different time of year?
So the coronal mass ejections that create these big storms can happen at any point in time during the year, but the best time to, if you're going to plan a trip to see the aurora, is March. That alignment of the Earth's dipole and the typical direction of the magnetic field in the solar wind is best for seeing aurora in that time of the year.
Absolutely fascinating. As we've said, Dr. Michael Wiltberger, we're loving all the pictures coming in. It's just beautiful. Again, thank you for your time, Michael Wiltberger, Dr. Michael Wiltberger with the National Center for Atmospheric Research.
And we have our trips booked.
We're doing it.
I've got to see that.
We've got to ask for our time off now. Yeah, now's the time to do it.
Now is the time.
But we are planning.
Okay, let's talk about the severe weather threat because that's a major concern for us. We're going to bring you the very latest on that and have a peek at the tropics.
We have some severe thunderstorm warnings that are active right now. We'll take a look at that, but also the heat. Ooh. It is still going in the southeast, including in Raleigh, North Carolina, 87 now, but the streak of 90s plus will continue.
At the Barrett Jackson Auto Auction, cars like these can go for a cool million easy. How? It starts with the details, and nobody does details like new Barrett Jackson Premium Auto Care. Liquid wax, formulated for a Barrett Jackson quality finish with advanced polymer technology for unbeatable protection and a residue-free shine, making your car look like a cool million by the people who know cars that look like a cool million. Oh. Try new Barrett Jackson Premium Liquid Car Wax, available at Walmart.
Make the cash call and ask for the do-over refi. If you refinanced your mortgage in the last 18 months, we can redo it at a lower rate, like today's 2.99% rate and APR, with no closing costs. Just call 855-890-CASH.
In the long term, climate change is a strategic threat. Example that I use all the time is what's happened in Mali. Agriculture was their main source of both revenue and food. Severe drought there over the last several years. They had to move. They went north. Well, they weren't welcome in the north. And as a consequence, there was a war in essence. We know climate change caused this.
The Weather Channel presents 25 Unexpected Voices. Hear their stories at climate25.com.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
It's a hard thing to break. Day in, day out. From point A to B and back again. There's a difference between being alive and living. For those who can't imagine life without two wheels, Allstate offers a genuine parts guarantee that promises to fix your bike with original parts. Talk to an Allstate agent about all the things they do to keep riders riding.
Americans, 83% try to eat healthy, yet up to 90% fall short in getting key nutrients from food alone. Let's do more. Add one-a-day women's gummies, complete with key nutrients we may need, plus it supports bone health with calcium and vitamin D. One-a-day VitaCraves gummies.
Are you missing out on life because you're putting off neck or back surgery? Laser Spine Institute, the leader in minimally invasive spine surgery, to learn how a less than 1-inch incision can have you up and walking within a few hours of surgery, free from chronic back pain, and with no hospital stay and no lengthy recovery. If you or a loved one have been diagnosed with spinal stenosis, bulging or herniated disc, sciatica, or other chronic conditions, call today for your MRI review.
When you're in that much pain and you live on painkillers, you really don't have quality of life. I feel like Laser Spine Institute was an answer to prayer. It's just the heavens had opened up, and it was like, I can live again.
If you've been told you might need neck or back surgery, call 1-855-401-BACK for your MRI review.
Laser Spine Institute, a less than 1-inch incision, a lifetime of standing tall.
As the host of a popular home improvement show, I know a lot about finding a great contractor for home repairs and improvement projects. Now there's HomeAdvisor.com, a free service that matches your project to top local service professionals.
We didn't have to do any work other than say what we needed.
Just 1, 2, 3, I found my guy and everything was smooth.
And it's always free to use.
We've had nothing but fabulous every single time.
Go to HomeAdvisor.com now to get started on your next project.
HomeAdvisor. So you take a chance on that slick DirecTV offer. $19, you think. But after just 3 months, you're paying over $100 a month, and it keeps going up. Suddenly, you're locked into a 2-year contract that could cost you nearly $3,000. Thinking about DirecTV? Better hang on to your wallet.
Don't fall for DirecTV's latest offer. There's nothing direct about DirecTV.
It drives and looks like new, you'll want to treat it like new. Certified pre-owned by BMW.
Now at Bremen BMW, get 0.9% financing, and BMW makes your first two payments.
New episode.
episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9 on the Weather Channel.
All right, welcome back. It's 53 past. Time to update you on what's happening now across the tropics. If you have a cruise plan across the Central Caribbean, nice weather, but the seas, you might want to bring your Dramamine. Look at the visible picture here. You can see the clouds, how quickly they're moving from the right part of your screen to the left part of your screen. That's the low-level flow out of the east. Easterly trade winds, that is building up the seas here across the Central Caribbean. 20-foot seas in some spots, so that's going to be the case this week if you have any plans to go out there. If you're headed down to Colombia or to Costa Rica, even down to Panama. Here across the Yucatan Channel, you notice this is a tropical disturbance, a wave in the atmosphere that's crossing the Yucatan Peninsula. Not a whole lot of deep convection, not seeing a lot of those rich, abundant thunderstorms in this one. Not expecting any development here. Another tropical disturbance, an area of convergence, winds coming together, producing this little disturbance here that's moving into the Bahamas. But here you can see, too, how the winds at the upper part of the atmosphere, Maria, are moving down to the southeast. A lot of wind shear here. Not expecting any development across the tropics over the next few days. Back to you.
All right, Michael, good information, too, about the cruises. Dramamine, a must. Okay, let's take a look at Seattle right now. You're looking at some sunshine and some cloudiness. Expected to get up to 80 today. You're on your way into the lower 70s. You're going to actually reach, though, by the weekend, the 90s, nearly 20 degrees above the average, and that's a big story across the Northwest. In the next few days, so many of us feeling that intense heat, and definitely going to see some records fall. Take a look at this list, all right? Portland, Oregon, Medford, Oregon, all getting to at or above 100 degrees, and it looks like both areas may safely break the record for the date on Saturday. Seattle and Spokane, too, within a few degrees, it could happen. Well, we have this very strong upper high in place, and that's a very dominant kind of thing. It keeps the air dry. It keeps any of the cold air from moving in, so you have no relief. So into the weekend, it's actually going to build to the north, and so you're going to even see more territory, more intense heat affected. Easily 15 to 25 degrees above average. Notice the one place, though, staying rather comfortable, closer to the coast, and that's really going to be key. You got to be careful out there with this kind of heat. A lot of areas, 99 Portland, close to 100, Medford, Spokane, Boise, even on into Saturday. And this is a part of the country where you have maybe 60-65% of homes with air conditioning. So think about what you're going to do to stay safe from the heat. Remember, beat the heat, check the back seat. It's going to be that kind of a stretch here. For Seattle, for example, your average high, 72 degrees. You are nowhere near that tomorrow, Friday, Saturday, or into Sunday. Kate?
In the southeast, it's a really similar story, Maria, and you have to check on those that are elderly. You know, if you have an elderly family member, if you have a family member that's sick or can't care for themselves, please make sure that they're somewhere where they are in air conditioning. You know, it's the Columbia, South Carolina heat, too. It's a very hot heat here. It's very humid. It's not just the air temperature. You have high humidity. The dew points are excessive. Look at the streak that you've been in of days over 90 degrees. But look, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. It comes in the form of the 80s. You thought the 80s were gone. No, 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 no. The 80s are here to stay for 2 days, all of two whopping days in the forecast. So that's looking pretty good, right? We'll take it because we are under a heat advisory for a lot of Arkansas, much of Mississippi, across Alabama, into Georgia, and up the Carolina coast. So we do have that heat advisory in place because of this high pressure. This has just been holding steady, created that ring of fire for a while, but you'll notice it's a little more elongated now, right? And Maria was just telling you all about that heat that's focused now in the southwest. You've got a little bit of a dip in the jet stream. I cannot get enough of this trough. I am so excited about it because once it gets here, those highs that are up to 10 degrees below average, we're going to see a little bit of an improvement. Now, it's not today and it's not tomorrow and it's not the next day, but as we get closer to the weekend and the start of next week, you are going to see at least a little bit of relief and you need it. 96 tomorrow in Atlanta, Nashville, 97 degrees. I mean, look at this. 95 in Raleigh, 92 in Wilmington. Just a lot of heat, but like I was saying, that trough, though, I need it.
All about
I need
troughs.
It in my life. That trough is going to help things out, I think, a little bit this weekend.
And it'll give everyone enough to get through to August.
Just
I think,
give
you know,
us a
just get
break.
Us by. All right, more severe weather coverage coming up with Mark Elliott and Vivian.
In 60 seconds.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. this afternoon. Sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Right now on Weather Center Live, scenes like this from the Midwest to the Northeast. Severe storms leaving behind a trail of damage and destruction. And unfortunately, it's not over yet. Today, we're tracking another round as we go through the afternoon and into tonight. Who's at risk? We'll tell you straight ahead.
And it's Lightning Awareness Week, and over the past few days, we've seen a lot of shots like this. Look at that, amazing shows in the sky as storms roll across several parts of the country. But we are here to make sure you don't become a victim of a lightning strike as severe weather ramps up again. It's our expert-filled in-depth coverage, and it starts right now on Weather Center Live.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Vivian Brown.
And I'm Mark Elliott. And we want to start this afternoon first by updating you on severe storms this week that have left behind trails of destruction.
And it all began at the start of the week. This is damage from Monday's tornadoes in the Midwest. The count so far, 9 confirmed tornadoes in Illinois. An EF3 with winds up to 160 miles per hour in Coal City on Monday. It's the strongest tornado in the Chicago metro area since late August of 1990. Unfortunately, the same area is in the threat again today for tornadic activity and those damaging straight-line winds.
And this is damage from a confirmed EF1 tornado that tore through Portland, Michigan on Monday. The tornado stayed on the ground for 10 minutes, winds about 100 miles per hour. There were no serious injuries. Here's the thing, though. The National Weather Service did not issue a warning on this storm. Forecasters say the tornado developed so fast, its signature was not detectable on radar until it was done. The tornado damaged about 70 homes, several businesses, and 3 churches.
And then the storms continued east. To look at the damage left as storms ripped through Camden County, New Jersey. This huge tree uprooted in Lindenwold, New Jersey, ripped right out of the ground. I mean, literally, as you could see, a giant piece of lawn and some sidewalk pulled up too. Wow.
Yeah, these were intense thunderstorms that ripped through New Jersey and Pennsylvania. A lot of destruction from the winds with these storms.
Yes, in Chester Heights, Pennsylvania, firefighters had to cut through a tree to reach one man trapped inside his home. Drew Smith of WCAU in Philadelphia has the story.
The fast-moving clouds came first, then the wind and rain, and within minutes, everything looked different.
Literally saw it. The first thing I thought was Wizard of Oz. You could barely, there was very little visibility. The trees were whipping around how fast the wind was going.
It was crazy. It was really insane.
Denise Hance says she's never experienced anything like this. She ordered her kids to huddle away from the windows.
Hiding underneath everything. And I'm, so girls, would just say your prayers. That's all we can do.
Traffic stopped moving, making it hard for ambulances and firefighters to respond to multiple emergencies.
We've been isolated. All the roads into our town have basically isolated us from any additional help.
At this home, Chester Heights rescuers had to cut through a tree to find a man who was originally on the second floor, which ended up crashing down to the ground. The man, his wife, and a hurt firefighter went to the hospital. Chris Walter worked to clear trees from driveways and streets as drivers ended up stuck.
2.5 hours, I've gone 2 miles. Trees everywhere down.
Walter worries about all the power lines now holding up fallen trees.
This is dangerous for people to be driving around like this.
It is, because it could actually let loose and drop on somebody.
Yeah, one of many examples from yesterday. Look at this. This is kind of a proxy for where the storms went. These are the storm reports over the past 24 hours. And you can see that all these storms, as they pushed towards the coast, wound up dropping trees and giving confirmed wind gusts. Some of the reports for you, Northumberland, right about 1 o'clock, thunderstorm wind damage. Trees and wires were down in the city there. A little bit later on, towards 4:30, there was some flash flooding being reported. Actually, a water rescue was needed on Lincoln Street, as and numerous water rescues. rescues in the Carlisle area as well. And these storms moved all the way to the coast. Widespread damage, including at that mall in South Jersey. Viv, over to you.
And you know, yesterday we were telling you about today's severe weather threat, and we told you it would be in this region, and that's exactly what we're watching again today, even into the overnight hours, anywhere from the Western High Plains all the way again to parts of the Midwest. So we'll be looking at another chance of some storms, maybe in and around Chicago, certainly around the Peoria area. Here is a look at the timing of the storms as we've kind of put on a future radar mode for you. You can see just north and east of the Des Moines area, those storms will start to fire and then cross over state lines into western Illinois. Chicago, we will be watching you. We think that first round will be to your south and west, but definitely pushing through the Peoria area with some locally heavy rains. And keep in mind now, this region of the country, pretty saturated. Many of the water tables are running fairly high. So we're talking about the threat of flash flooding too. And that's why flash flood watches have been issued to encompass much of northwestern Indiana into northern Illinois, even back into the central parts of Iowa near the Des Moines area. Here is the setup. We basically have this warm front here. It's the dividing line with very warm air being pulled northward, and it's going to override the slightly cooler air mass to the north of it. And it is that overrunning moisture pattern that's going to set the stage at the surface for the storms to develop. And with the jet stream going parallel right over the same region, we're kind of setting the stage for one storm after another to roll over the same area. So that's why those flood watches have been issued, because an additional 2 to 3 inches are possible, and even more than 3 inches in some cases. Back to you, Mark.
And Viv, you just showed us Chicago right there on the northern fringes of some of those storm paths, according to the high resolution models. But you can't put your guard down in Chi-Town, because if you're going to see storms, the timing here shows you that they show up overnight. Check out the timestamp, right? From 12 a.m. all the way into the morning commute time, that's when you have your chance for strong thunderstorms to roll through Chicago. So even as you go to sleep, it may not be storming yet. If you're going to see storms, they may occur well after dark. As we jump forward out of Chicago and in towards Peoria, much more likely for Peoria to see several rounds of storms today. So the flood threat may be a little bit higher here because the grounds will already be saturated. You're going to see a big round of storm chances coming in and late evening into the beginning of the overnight, and then another continuation through the night. Strong storms potentially will continue to roll on through here, Viv. Peoria, check this out. Look at the amount of moisture that is coming through this region, right up to 2 inches Thursday, and then through the overnight, it continues maybe even to as much as over 3 inches of rain. This is why flooding is a threat here for the Peoria area. In Minnesota, missing a lot of the storms, but there could be some storms popping up for Des Moines. We're watching it carefully for you. We'll show you where the storm threat will continue when we return.
Food should be good. People should dance. Strawberries should sing. Good bread makes a sandwich. Good soil makes a salad. Lettuce should be dirty. Dressing, clean. Sweet should never be fake. Manners, never mind it. Debate should be healthy. Hatchets buried. Forks on the left, knives on the right. Hands should be used regardless. Bellies should be rocked. Tables should be full. And good food should be good for you. We're not saying these are the rules we should all live by, but it's a good place to start. Panera, food as it should be.
Nice job, guys. And it'll last, too, because I'm the only paint and primer in one with Easy Wash Formula, which you may find pretty handy someday.
Olympic One Paint stands up to 1,500 scrubs, exclusively at Lowe's.
Are you a man over 40 and feeling tired, losing muscle, have less romantic drive? Then you need Ageless Male, with an ingredient clinically shown to increase free testosterone levels. Ageless Male is now available at these fine retailers.
Sunday, on an all-new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods.
For these three radio DJs, this is a nightmare.
What are we going to do for food?
I mean, that's what we're doing, man. It's real simple. Kill it and eat it.
A new episode of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sunday at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Morning tracking storms that could bring wind damage and flooding into your Thursday commute. Plus, will we finally get relief from the southern heat? Wake up with Al and AMHQ tomorrow morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to EverGrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
With Michelin tires, rainy days aren't so tricky.
Let's do this. Don't think it's possible? Think again. With the summer's best savings, the upgrades are better than ever. So, let's go for the bells and the whistles. Fridges that open like this. And, whoa, did you see that? It's time to reset our expectations. Right now, it's all within reach. Let's do this. Get a Samsung washer, dryer, or fridge, each just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
When I'm out in the hot sun, I know how to hydrate on the inside. But what about my skin?
Coppertone Sports Sunscreen puts a breathable layer on your skin to help keep it hydrated by holding in natural moisture while providing protection from harmful UV rays.
Game on.
Coppertone Sport.
Well, look at this. Deptford, New Jersey hit hard as severe storms rolled through the area. In fact, power in part New Jersey and Pennsylvania still out this morning, and how could it not be? You're looking at shots there of a mall, the Deptford Mall, where the metal roofing and siding just scoured away. Look at that. Those are solar panels on the roof that were peeled back as if they were nothing. Cars were flipped in the parking lot. The storm downed trees as well. Dangerous straight-line winds rolled through this area, Viv.
Meanwhile, in Rhode Island, the National Weather Service in Boston is sending a crew to survey the damage. They're working to determine if the damage in the state was the result of straight-line winds or, in fact, a tornado. Nonetheless, winds were clocked up to 70 miles per hour, were reported, of course, in the Rhode Island area, resulting in downed trees and power lines.
How about this? Washington, D.C., nearly an inch of rain in just an hour. Not exactly baseball weather. 55-mile-per-hour winds reported at Reagan National Airport. So the rain was pouring down between 7 and 8 last night, delaying the Nationals and the Braves game. So the teams finally hit the field after a 2-hour, 12-minute rain delay, and they tweeted out, "Thanks for sticking with us, fans."
Well, right now, a live look at Chicago's severe, dangerous storms this week, including an EF3 rated tornado in the metro area. This afternoon, though, we're keeping a close eye on more storms now that could turn severe and even lead to some intense flooding. But again, it's pretty quiet right now in the Chicago area, but keep your guards up. Okay, here's a look. We're tracking the severe weather through late week over a good part of the Midwest. You can see those high clouds that have pushed through the Chicago area. Still some colder and higher cloud tops working across this general corridor. So for the rest of the day, we're still setting the stage in the atmosphere for more storms to develop. And even overnight tonight, anywhere you see the red shading on this map, that's where we will be tracking another round of storms. The setup like this, the moist flow still in place. There's your warm front, kind of the dividing line from the warmer, moist air and slightly cooler and drier air to the north of it. But it is is that overrunning moisture pattern that's going to set the stage right near the warm front for more showers and storms to develop. And then, of course, with the jet stream winds flowing right over this, we'll find one storm after another feed across the same grounds here over the Midwest. And for that reason, again, we do have flood advisories that have been issued because the grounds are still running a little high in terms of saturation. Now, tomorrow, a lot of that energy will be transported over into the Ohio Valley and toward the Mid-Atlantic through the evening and overnight hours here. So we'll be following this whole area for the next 24 to 36 hours. Friday, still focusing our attention back across parts of the Midwest into the central parts of Missouri even. So Friday, tracking more severe storms. Mark?
Thanks, Viv. And you know, with that flood threat in place tonight, we have to talk about why that flooding is so dangerous, especially if you're in a car, because nearly half of all flood fatalities happen in a vehicle. Water weighs a lot, 62.4 pounds per cubic foot, and as it generally flows downstream at 6 to 12 miles per hour, it exerts all kinds of force on those vehicles. So when a vehicle stalls out in that water, the water's momentum is transferred into the car, right? For every foot of water, you get 500 pounds of lateral force, left to right force, if you will, applied to the car. But that's not even the biggest factor with regards to flooding fatalities. No, the biggest factor is buoyancy. The car displaces the water around it, and it really, for every foot of water that you have on the road, the car weighs about 1,500 pounds less. So it only takes about 2 feet to float a vehicle away. My goodness, very dangerous situation. And we could see a situation like this tonight because of that flooding rain setup, as storms will go over the same areas again and again. Don't drive through any flooded roads. And if you don't have to travel tonight, don't do it at all.
Now everyone who uses catheters can get a better catheter with Liberator Medical's free catheter sample pack. These new catheters are better than ever. Easier to use, more convenient, comfortable, virtually pain-free. Don't wait. Call now and get your free catheter sample pack. There's the all-new compact catheter for women. Pre-lubricated, no drips, no mess. Fits in your purse. The self-lubricated catheter. It lubricates itself in the package. Comfortable, no mess. The closed system catheter, pre-lubricated with its own collection bag, proven to reduce UTIs. The discreet pocket catheter, curved to fit in your pocket to go anywhere. The polished eyelet catheter for micro-smooth comfort, reduces friction and pain. Call now. We'll also bill Medicare and your insurance for you. Call for your free catheter sample pack with free shipping. Call Liberator Medical.
Call 1-800-601-3450. That's 1-800-601-3450.
Here at TD Ameritrade, they love innovating, and apparently, they also love stickers.
What's up with these things, Victor?
We decided to give ourselves stickers for each feature we release.
New feature.
We read about 10,000 suggestions a week to create features that, as traders, we'd want to use. Like social signals, a tool that uses social media to help with research.
10,000 suggestions? Who reads all of those?
Another feature.
He does.
For all the confidence you need, TD Ameritrade, you got this.
Climate change, of course, has a lot to do with the Middle East, more than people realize. After all, Syria experienced the worst drought in its modern history from 2006 to 2010. Those were the 4 years leading up to the Syrian revolution.
The Weather Channel presents 25 Unexpected Voices. Hear their stories at climate25.com.
You pay your car insurance premium like clockwork, month after month, year after year. Then one night, you hydroplane into a ditch. Yeah. Surprise, your insurance company tells you to pay up again. Why pay for insurance if you have to pay even more for using it?
If you have Liberty Mutual Deductible Fund, you could pay no deductible at all. Sign up to immediately lower your deductible by $100 and keep lowering it $100 annually until it's gone. Then continue to earn that $100 every year. There's no limit to how much you can earn, and this savings applies to every vehicle on your policy. Call 1-844-530-9771 to learn more. Switch to Liberty Mutual, and you could save up to $423. Call Liberty Mutual for a free quote today at 1-844-530-9771. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Tomorrow morning, tracking storms that could bring wind damage and flooding into your Thursday commute. Plus, when we finally get relief from the southern heat. Wake up with Al and AMHQ tomorrow morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Stay tuned for your local on the 8, brought to you by Off Mosquito Protection.
The Off Outdoor Refresher Course. Gatherings. Extended family, meet crowded living space. Claustrophobia, meet vitophobia. It's time to unlearn your fear. Step 1, open door. Step 2, light off mosquito lamp. It protects an area up to 10 times larger than the leading citronella candle. Step 3, enjoy the air. Between you and the in-laws, get back out there with Off Mosquito Lamp. Keep bugs off.
SC Johnson, a family company.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
To Weather Center Live. Check out the lightning over Hoboken, New Jersey. It was part of that system that moved through the New York metro area yesterday. Now, some of the heaviest damage reported just north of Ridgefield, where a state of emergency is in effect due to power outages and downed trees.
That Anthony Quintana always gets the best views.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you can hear the excitement there. How could you not? There's lightning in Parsons, Tennessee last night. My goodness, Parsons between Memphis and Nashville. Now look at that. You got clouds of ground. You got crawlers going across the anvil, filling the sky. I would have sounded like that in the car, too, Viv.
We don't want you to get too excited now because, I mean, lightning can be very, very dangerous. So please be careful. But take a look at this lightning streaking across the Dearborn, Michigan sky. This is just outside of Detroit. Thunderstorms produced record rainfall in Detroit last night, 1.08 inches. The city also saw dangerous lightning strikes, as you can see, some 2,500 strikes in just 1 hour.
My goodness, magnificent video coming in today. And in Tampa, the heat and humidity along the coast bringing thunderstorms last night. Ooh, that was loud, right? Thunderstorms came through. Tampa sees about 1,500 lightning strikes in just 1 hour. That's what they saw with that storm as it rolled through Tampa Bay. So we want to talk more about the lightning strikes, where they happen, and where, unfortunately, people are killed by them, because it is a very dangerous meteorological event here.
Well, I do want to start off with some good news, and that is that we don't have nearly as many annual lightning strikes so far this year, the last decade, than we had, say, in the late 40s.
Yeah, that's the trend that we want to see, that's for sure, but every one is one too many, and this is how it often happens. A lot of it is during leisure activities. And a lot of that is water-related, whether it's outside on boats or in pools. Water somehow becomes a real big conductor of electricity, and so water and electricity, as you know, don't mix.
All right, so only 4% of lightning fatalities are a result of unknown, but that means 96% of all other lightning fatalities are associated with outdoor activities. And again, that is not good. That's why we always say, when you hear thunder roar, go indoors.
So let's talk more about those water-related activities, because that is such an overwhelming majority of those leisure activities when lightning strikes and actually kills someone. A lot of it is fishing. Fishermen are put at risk all the time holding those big metal rods. They're the highest point on the water when they're out there fishing.
Mm-hmm. I mean, are all fishing poles metal? I mean, do they have wooden fishing poles? That may be a little bit better.
Some, but most of them now have metal. But even so, you're holding an object up into the sky, so it becomes the highest point. Yeah. And lots of of lightning strikes cloud to ground by city, by area, I should say. Florida is the capital for the U.S.
Oh, definitely. And then even Mississippi, number three on the list here in terms of lightning strikes. So please be careful, in particular over parts of the South.
Now, let's look live at Omaha, Nebraska. An ominous sky there. We actually just saw a lightning strike go by on that camera. Lots of low clouds. We've got some rain moving in. This is going to be the trend today, and we have more storms to track right now.
All right, as we look at our latest in-hand satellite picture, you can see those high clouds just pushing east of the Omaha area. Three separate areas of distinction, so let's show you how they translate to the radar, and there you see three separate areas. Let's go west to east, and we'll start with this one here in western South Dakota, Mark.
This one may very well turn into the big event for the rest of the day. Uh-huh. These storms will kind of coalesce into a complex system and move down along that warm front, and there have been some severe thunderstorm warnings outside Rapid City.
And developing along that warm front, we have another pretty big cluster, and look at this one. I mean, it seems to be bowing out just west of the Des Moines area. Severe thunderstorm warning out on this one now for the Carroll and Crawford and Sac counties, so please be careful here moving through the Carroll area.
Yeah, that one's surging forward. Meanwhile, along that warm front, we've had some kind of precursor rains just moistening up the ground, setting the stage for flooding as the next rounds come in later.
In a world of fake, fried, and frozen, Boston Market promises to make food good. Like our all-natural rotisserie chicken. Now meals start at just $6.99. Boston Market, all good.
Six smoky hours, one tasty dish, slow-braised pulled pork, now at Boston Market.
We fight a war against every foul pest that haunts your home. Backed by 85 years of experience and the strongest guarantee in the business, it's not exactly a fair fight. Not here, not now, not in my house. Terminix.
Have you ever struggled to get out of the car? Does back or knee pain make it hard? Do you push with your arm when you try to stand? Or ask someone to give you a hand? Then let us help you out with the incredible new Car Cane. Now you can get in and out of your car with ease. This new portable handle locks instantly into the door latches of any car. The non-slip grip is comfortable to hold. It gives you the leverage to lift yourself up. Simply open your door and snap it on. Car Cane locks into place and will not move. In fact, Car Cane's forged steel construction can hold 350 pounds. Amazing! Then, Car Cane unlocks and stores away easily in the door or glove box. If you are recovering from an injury or suffer from back pain, knee pain, or hip pain, you need the Car Cane. And when it's slippery outside, Car Cane gives you a handy grip so you won't slip. It's perfect for those tall SUVs or low compact cars too. So stop struggling and get up with ease.
It was difficult to get out on my own. And asking for help is embarrassing. Now I carry my Car Cane and help myself. Car Cane is a lifesaver.
My Car Cane gave me my freedom back.
We guarantee Car Cane is so well built, it will last a lifetime or your money back. So call and get your Car Cane today for just $19.95 plus processing and handling. But wait, call right now and we'll upgrade you to the deluxe Car Cane with a built-in flashlight. These super bright LEDs can last 100,000 hours without burning out. Now you'll always have a light when you need it the most. So help yourself out. Get your Car Cane today.
To order your Car Cane Deluxe, call 1-800-713-8360 or go to carcane.com. That's 1-800-713-8360 or order online at carcane.com.
Attention Benicar users. Benicar may cause injuries, including serious abdominal pain, chronic diarrhea, and other stomach problems. You may be entitled to financial compensation. A recent medical study reports injuries caused by the blood pressure medicine Benicar, including abdominal pain, vomiting, ongoing diarrhea, and other stomach problems. If you or a loved one experienced injuries while using Benicar, call now. You may be entitled to financial compensation.
Call 1-855-249-4191. That's 1-855-249-4191.
Glad you're with us right here on AMHQ, the whole team.
Right, either go all in or just tap out.
Here we go. I told you, we're going to bust out of this drought.
As we say, keep watching with us this morning because we're all watching history happen together.
Currently in our area, 90 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. this afternoon. Sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
New episodes of Fat Guys in the Woods, Sundays at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Right now, still more than 130,000 people without power after severe storms blasted through the tri-state. New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Delaware included here as well. Winds topping 70 miles per hour. At one point last night, nearly 500,000 people in the Philadelphia area alone lost power completely in the dark as those storms blasted through. PATCO, the high-speed train service in the area, not running today. It's the first service outage since Superstorm Sandy, which shows you the strength of these storms that blasted by. Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. It is 30 past the hour here on Weather Center Live. I'm Mark Elliott.
And I'm Vivian Brown. I'll tell you what, the D.C. area to Boston, all the way to Rhode Island, the Northeast hit hard yesterday by severe storms.
Yes, 70-mile-per-hour winds whipped across parts of Pennsylvania, downing trees and power lines. I mean, just look at that video. You can feel the strength of these storms as the trees bend to the wind. This morning, some of the train service around Philadelphia was suspended. Again, that PATCO line because of the power outages. And New Jersey Transit was shut down between Philly and Atlantic City. So much tree damage to clean up along those rail lines. They had to make sure that everything was working before starting up the trains again.
Oh, meanwhile, in Maryland, howling winds up to 67 miles per hour. Driver was killed when he hit a tree that fell across the road.
And lightning was one of the big threats in Hoboken, New Jersey. Some intense strikes near the water. Anthony Quintano just always seems to be in the right spot for videos like this. Looking across the river towards Hoboken, and man, about 200 lightning strikes between 5:30 and 6:30 last evening as those storms blasted through, and then an epic sunset behind it as well.
Oh yes, it was beautiful after the storms, but you know what? The heavy rain fell on Manhattan as well, and an even stronger portion of the storm cell moved through during rush hour. Now, Brooklyn picked up about a third of an inch in a short time. Needless to say, this afternoon, the cleanup continues across the Northeast.
It's going to go. If that wind is crazy. Oh, it's going to go. There it goes. There it goes.
It's gone.
There it goes. It missed the whole, every house.
And we are still tracking storms for the rest of today into tonight. They are really going to be ramping up, this time in the Midwest, although we do have some storms firing off right now. Here's the Atlanta metro area. Briefly, we had some storms blasting through. But yes, tracking storms through the night, through the late week. Let's show you the wide view of the radar. We have three different areas that we're watching, 1, 2, and 3, all along a warm front, and that's not moving much. So the same areas are going to see storms going over time and time again tonight. That's why we have a flood threat. Right now, some of the worst of the weather is in Iowa, right along I-80, Des Moines. We've got this complex of storms trying to get organized, trying to bow out towards you. Gusty winds will be one of the biggest threats. But we're not done. Just if you have one round of storms go through, tonight you could see another round go by. So tonight, from Rapid City all the way down through Chicago, Champaign, you've got that chance for severe weather, mostly in the form of very gusty winds. Can't rule out hail or isolated tornadoes either. Using the high-resolution models, we can time out what's going to happen with these storms. That cluster from Iowa by this evening, by the commute time, will be rolling across northern Illinois, then drop into central Illinois through the beginning of the night. But another round tries to set up again in central Iowa as we go through the late night hours, and these two will send storms going over these same areas again and again and again. Like train cars on a track, they're following the warm front and following the upper level winds. That's what's pushing these along. So again, with the same zones getting hit by rain time and time again. Flash flooding is a concern. Here's another way to show you why we're so concerned about this area. It's a very slow-moving warm front. Abundant moisture is already in place. The low-level winds are following that front. We also have the jet stream winds just north of the front, all in the same direction. So that's the storm path. They are going to be a parade of storms tonight, and flooding is a big concern. Viv, over to you.
Well, you said it, Mark. The entire Midwestern region, the target area for more storms as we work deeper into the evening hours and overnight tonight. But let's get city-specific, and we'll start with Chicago because we think it'll be around the midnight hour that those storms could really start to fire, and they very well could continue right on into the wee hours of tomorrow morning. Peoria, Illinois, the same for you, maybe starting a little earlier. This is, of course, that second round of storms as we look at 11 o'clock tonight through midnight. And again, as you can see, right on into the wee hours of the morning tomorrow for you, Peoria, as well. In fact, as we go through the next several 24 hours, should I say, we're talking about additional heavy amounts of rain. So it's a lot of moisture associated with some of these storms, with those heavier downpours. So today's severe threat could produce high winds and the damaging hailstones, again, and locally heavy rain as well. Mark?
You know, we've been following today's severe threat with the winds and hail, but storm tracker Jim Cantore is in the lab. He is going to show us the different sizes of hail and what damage each one can cause.
And when we think of winds, we think about what comes at our face and what blows in the horizontal. But this will be a vertical wind, what we call an updraft that supports, helps to grow this hail and can produce hail anywhere from pea size to softball size to even bigger hail than that. We're going to show you that in just a moment. Of course, when you think of hail, it doesn't get a lot of attention, right? Tornadoes get most of the attention when you're talking about big thunderstorms, but hail can cause billions of dollars worth of damage. All right, what does it take in terms of updraft strength to produce pea size hail, which of course is the smallest hail we typically get here to hit the ground? Well, about 35 miles per hour. That wind will be blowing 35 miles per hour. Suspend those super cool water droplets. They'll start to coalesce, and voila, we've got ourselves ice. They can grow bigger than that. Quarter size hail, 49 mile per hour updraft. Now we're getting up there in terms of the speed. Let's say those quarters are still there and the updraft increases in strength. You can actually grow that hail to become as big as golf ball size. Absolutely, golf ball size hail. Stones that big. And once you get that big, you've got big problems on your hand because golf balls can cause damage to roofs, to cars, even the sides of buildings. These come out of the cloud at over 100 miles an hour on average. And when they come down just a little bit off of the vertical, you're talking about something that bangs into the side of buildings. Looks like somebody opened up an AK-47. Stones can continue to grow as long as the updraft strength is strong. Baseball size hail. Winds, 81 miles per hour to help support this. And remember, the stones don't go up and down in the whole thunderstorm. They just kind of sit there. They float. There's all this super cool water droplets that exist with temperatures below 32 degrees, which is where these stones are, and they just continue to add to this. Sometimes you get different sized stones that bang together, and you get one big jagged stone. Well, we can get bigger hail than baseball. Teacup size hail, 3 inches in diameter, takes 85 mile per hour winds. And if you're going 85 on the interstate, what does that mean? You're probably getting a ticket. Stones can get bigger than teacups. They can get to softball size. You're talking about 4.5 inch diameter hail. It takes a 103 mile per hour updraft to suspend a 4.5 inch diameter hail stone. And if it comes down, it's gonna cause damage to anything that it hits. The biggest hailstone that we've ever seen in the history of the United States that at least has been officially measured was in Vivian, South Dakota on July 23rd, 2010. This thing was huge. 8 inches across, 18.62 inches in diameter. It weighed nearly 2 pounds. And to give you a size comparison, it's almost as big as a soccer ball. I mean, look at the size of this thing. So if I put this next to my head, this was about as big as that hailstone. Could you imagine being outside without a helmet in this?
Jim's head-sized hailstone. No thanks.
No thanks.
No
exactly.
Thanks.
Very dangerous. As we look outside of Atlanta right now, we have the dark clouds overhead. We're watching some storms off to the east right now. We've even had penny-sized hailstones associated with some of these storms. There you see the radar.
Yeah, 60-mile-per-hour wind, so a severe thunderstorm warning over Cobb County. Not too far away from the Weather Channel headquarters, so the studio is rocking now. We can hear the thunder. Lots of lightning. Highly electrified storms moving towards the I-75, I-85 connector.
currently in our area, 89 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
When the moment's spontaneous, why pause to take a pill? Or stop to find a bathroom? Cialis for daily use is approved to treat both erectile dysfunction and the urinary symptoms of BPH, like needing to go frequently, day or night. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions and medicines and ask if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Do not drink alcohol in excess. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. To avoid long-term injury, get medical help right away for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. If you have any sudden decrease or loss in hearing or vision, or any symptoms of an allergic reaction, stop taking Cialis and get medical help right away. Ask your doctor about Cialis for daily use and the free 30-tablet trial.
Looks like the Garcias got a new car.
What'd they get?
I don't know.
Sure doesn't look like a Buick.
Buick.
I'm outside. Where are you?
I'm right here. I'm in the Buick.
I don't see a Buick.
Take a fresh look at Buick. It just might surprise you.
That's not a Buick. That's what I told him.
Wow. This is nice.
Oh, my.
Now get nearly $7,200 total value on specially equipped 2015 Enclave models.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
Let's do this. Don't think it's possible? Think again. With the summer's best savings, the upgrades are better than ever. So, let's go for the bells and the whistles. Fridges that open like this. And, whoa, did you see that? It's time to reset our expectations. Right now, it's all within reach. Let's do this. Get a Samsung washer, dryer, or fridge, each just $9.98. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
You've worked hard your whole life, and now it's your time. Your retirement the way you want it. But you need to know that your financial resources are going to last the distance. We all do. Well, AAG is the number one reverse mortgage lender in the country. And it's the job of these folks to make sure that you have access to the resources you need. And I can tell you, they take that job and your retirement very seriously.
More and more people are using a reverse mortgage line of credit to make sure they have the funds they need when they want it. Some people use it to delay Social Security, so they get much more each month later in life. And some keep the line of credit available as extra funds for those rainy days.
It's also cash you can access while your other assets might not be bringing in what you need. It can provide you with cash from your home's equity when you need it, while you're still living in the place you love.
If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you may qualify for a government-insured reverse mortgage from AAG. Turn your home's equity into tax-free cash while allowing your line of credit to grow over time. What more could you want from your retirement plans? Call us today to receive a free information pack with no obligation that contains a helpful 3-part guide and DVD. You'll receive a guide to reverse mortgages and how they work, including the many consumer safeguards that protect you and your home. Also, our important all-new reverse mortgage retirement planner that explains the many ways a reverse mortgage could provide stability and security for your retirement. We then add a guide filled with information for children and loved ones. It's got what you need to know about reverse mortgages and how they can play a vital role in your retirement plans.
Call 1-800-817-8185 to receive your all-new information pack with added reverse mortgage retirement planner guide. Call 1-800-817-8185.
AAG, the best advice for a better life.
Well, it is hot in Phoenix. How hot is it, you ask? Well, it's so hot that crews have to cool the concrete mix with custom misters before they can lay it down. It has to stay at 90 degrees while it's being transported, and if they don't have misters, sometimes plain old ice water can do the trick. You would never think about it from that perspective, but once again, it proves that weather impacts practically everything we do. So as I always say, we are together in weather in more ways than you think. Right, Mark?
Absolutely, Viv. And you know that heat is only going to build further in the northwest. A live look here towards Seattle. My goodness, it is really going to be baking, especially by the time we get into the weekend. If you think it's hot now out west, just wait. That ridge is going to continue to build on in. And we're talking not only record-breaking heat, but potentially life-threatening heat as we look towards the west. This could enter the record books, that's for sure. Let's start things off here by checking out the Seattle area. It is really going to be quite substantial by the weekend. Sure, it's warm for now and the next couple of days in the mid-80s, but by the weekend, closer to 90. And the Portland area will be closer to 100. These areas only average these types of temperatures about once a year. So this is notable heat. Strong upper high is building on in. Look how far north it punches that jet stream. Everyone underneath this upside-down U is going to be dealing with above-average temperatures and sweltering conditions. Highs, especially in the Pacific Northwest, though, 15 to 25 degrees above your average. So for this time of year, that means stuff like this. Portland, Friday, near 100. But look at Medford, 110 or so. Saturday, Portland, getting to 100. That's when Seattle gets near 90. Spokane, near 103. Boise, 107. Sunday, more of the same. Upper 80s, low 90s, into the 100s. Dangerous heat, and we're talking records. Portland could see records. Seattle could see records. Spokane could see records. Viv, this is a substantial heat wave.
Oh, yeah. Hot over the Northwest, but it's also sweltering over parts of the South as well. You're looking right now live across Atlanta from the camera with a smile. That's the Coca-Cola World Headquarters camera, of course. We are watching some isolated thunderstorms. In fact, just to the east of the city, north and east of the city, we do have some isolated thunderstorms being reported right now, Atlanta. So a thunderstorm perhaps cooling you off temporarily, but the bigger weather story over the southeast is the heat, including, again, Atlanta. Look at tomorrow's high, 96 degrees, and then on Friday, 92. Oh, some relief on Saturday, perhaps, 83 by then, as we will be below our average high, which is about 88 degrees. So again, with these mid-90s, we are even hotter than we should be this time of year in Atlanta. Not only Atlanta, but the entire Southeast. Look at Columbia, South Carolina, 16 days and counting with over 90 degrees. We even got over 100 between the 15th and the 18th. Those were four sweltering days in the Columbia, South Carolina area. And look at this. We're talking about more 90 degree heat, at least until maybe next Sunday. We talk about 84 degrees by then in Columbia, South Carolina. So that will be a huge break from this extreme heat wave that we've dealt with. Okay, let's look at the overall picture. Tomorrow, again, even in Columbia, 98 degrees, Atlanta, 96. And when you factor in the humidity, you know, it feels even hotter. It feels like it'll be over 100 degrees in many cases. And that's why we have heat advisories spread out all across the deep South. Mark?
And in that heat and humidity, we have storms exploding. Check out this view. You can see that in the center of your screen, that is a rain shaft. The clouds absolutely opening up, pouring down rain there. Chris is sending this one in. My goodness, what a shot there. And we could see some very gusty winds as that rain pulls down all that rain-cooled air. We are looking at a wind and hail threat here in the southeast. A brand new severe thunderstorm watch has been issued from Alabama into Georgia, much of the state of Georgia, actually, under that severe thunderstorm watch goes all the way through the rest of the day, through the peak heating time, until 10 o'clock this evening. We are looking at the big storms developing here. We'll show you exactly where they are. Your severe weather update coming up next.
At the Barrett Jackson Auto Auction, cars like these can go for a cool million easy. How? It starts with the details, and nobody does details like new Barrett Jackson Premium Auto Care. Liquid wax, formulated for a Barrett Jackson quality finish with advanced polymer technology for unbeatable protection and a residue-free shine, making your car look like a cool million by the people who know cars that look like a cool million. Try new Barrett Jackson Premium Liquid Car Wax, available at these fine retailers.
Make the cash call and ask for the do-over refi. If you refinanced your mortgage in the last 18 months, we can redo it at a lower rate, like today's 2.99% rate and APR, with no closing costs. Just call 855-890-CASH.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is a large and dangerous tornado.
That's why we get real local the moment you need it.
We are live in Oklahoma, Arkansas, Mississippi, Florida.
Real accurate.
This is round one of the severe storms that are coming through.
From real experts on the ground.
That is a gust front for you right there in Dusty, Texas. Wow.
Where you get your weather matters.
This is basically what makes the Weather Channel
great. Keep the Weather Channel on.
Here at the Weather Channel.
The Weather Channel is out in full force today.
Only the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 89 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Fiat 500X crossover. With 70 standard and available safety features, including options like all-wheel drive and blind spot monitoring, it's eye candy that watches the road.
No! And just like that, the snow is gone. And parkas become jackets. And sweaters go down for a long nap. And off you go. And your backyard gets a whole lot bigger. And you're running and climbing. And your gear gets lighter and trimmer and fitter and smarter. And now every frozen second spent willing this day to come is just a warm, fading memory.
There's a more enjoyable way to get your fiber. Try Philips Fiber Good Gummies Plus Energy Support. It's a new fiber supplement that helps support regularity and includes B vitamins to help convert food to energy.
These are good.
Nice work, Phillips.
The tasty side of fiber from Phillips.
Food should be good. Strawberry should sing. Lettuce should be dirty. Dressing clean. Debate should be healthy. Hatchets buried. Tables should be full. And good food should be good for you. We're not saying these are the rules we should all live by. But it's a good place to start. Panera, food as it should be.
At last.
Sometimes at last doesn't happen at first.
My love has come along. My lonely days.
Your dad just kissed my mom.
Are over.
Turning two worlds into one takes love.
And life is like a song.
Helping protect that world takes State Farm.
It's time to bid farewell to this booking incredible island resort and its incredible island staff.
I can't imagine life without them. This is not goodbye.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Okay, I guess it's not. You got it booking right. Booking.com. Booking. Yeah.
I never thought there was hope that I would get clean because I've been trying for many years. I got clean at 39. I could honestly say I've been trying since 23. There were many nights that I went to bed that I didn't think I was going to wake up. I had taken so many pills and I didn't think I'd wake up. And there were some days where I felt like my heart was like really speeding along, and that's how bad my life got. You know, thank God I don't have to live like that anymore.
Tomorrow morning, tracking storms that could bring wind damage and flooding into your Thursday commute. Plus, when we finally get relief from the southern heat. Wake up with Al and AMHQ tomorrow morning at 5, only on the Weather Channel.
Right now, it is 53 minutes past the hour, and throughout the show, we've shown you some pretty amazing video stemming from yesterday's storms, and we want to show you even more of the power of Mother Nature. Check out the view from Fenway Park last night. Oh my goodness, these towering cumulonimbus clouds, of course, over Fenway Park after the strong winds rolled through the area. The game was delayed by more than 2 hours. Unfortunately, the Red Sox did lose the game. They were playing the Baltimore Orioles, and the final score was 6-4. And this is damage that was left behind in parts of Ohio. This is actually Greenwich, New Jersey yesterday. Debris everywhere, and some of the debris was parts of a roof that was blown off of some of the buildings. You could see large pieces of debris in the area. Dangerous situation and a big mess, of course, to clean up. Meanwhile, in Ohio, strong winds here. These gusty winds swept along Lake Erie and dumped about an inch of rain, knocking out power and split several trees. More than 20 homes were damaged in the city of Eastlake by the falling trees. Of course, these are huge, mature trees as well. And many of the trees actually blocked some of the roads, making, of course, harder for the cleanup crews to get to the areas that were damaged very heavily. And it is going to be a long way of recovery, of course, over parts of Ohio. Now, those are all of the details from the storms that we had just yesterday. And unfortunately, the storms expected again today over parts of the Midwest. Let's go out to the lab with a severe weather update and Mark.
Thanks, Viv. Yeah, we've got more storms developing as we speak. In fact, away from the Midwest in that corridor, which we'll see more storms today, we've got another round of storms that's firing up here in the southeast. There's actually a new severe thunderstorm watch much of northern and central Georgia into Alabama. Severe thunderstorm watch for the rest of the day. But notice all of these little yellow boxes. These are severe thunderstorm warnings. They're being issued because of half-inch hail and 60-mile-per-hour winds. Zooming in a little bit closer now, we've got the Atlanta metro area. Here's Cobb County. In fact, the Weather Channel headquarters is right about here, so we are getting rocked by this storm as well. Very gusty winds, reports of trees down across the area, so this is something to be wary of. Here's the I-75 corridor. If you're anywhere between Atlanta and Marietta, we've got this storm rolling through. In fact, we've got a live look at the Atlanta metro area right now. We've been watching these cameras. Here's a picture that came in. Look at this. The sky's absolutely opening up. You can see the rain shaft there in the center of the picture. It looks like someone poked a hole in that cloud and just allowed the rain to come through. And then here's a live view. This is from atop the Coca-Cola World Headquarters building. And we have been following this view as well because they're looking off towards the north at those big storms that are still developing. Several rounds of storms today across the southeast. Meanwhile, we're looking towards the Midwest as well. A corridor of storms here are following a front that is barely moving. So time and time again, we're going to see rounds of storms. We had one round come through central Illinois. We've got another round moving through Iowa and a third moving right over Rapid City. These clusters of storms have the potential to organize today, give you some very gusty winds and some flooding rains as well. In fact, right now we've got a severe thunderstorm warning. This is the I-90 corridor here, Spearfish. We're just to the north and west of Rapid City. This one producing some big time hail, so we're following that for you as it rolls on off towards the south and east. We're also following central Iowa. Des Moines has been seeing some big storms, but we're not done. This whole corridor is going to see some big time storms through the rest of the day into tonight. In fact, using the high resolution models, Viv, we can see that this storm just continues to roll on through, and flooding rains will be a factor as we go through the nighttime hours. Over to you.
All right, we're tracking in timing of more potentially dangerous storms as we go through the evening. It continues at the top of the hour. So as we go to break, we're going to take you back to yesterday and show you just how bad it really was and how you need to keep your guards up for more storms again today.
Currently in our area, 89 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, sunshine and clouds mixed. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 91. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 78. Thursday, partly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 92. Here's our 7-day outlook.